The containers that I've created so far have all been ephemeral. I've not been able to see what's inside the container. How does it look and feel like? So I'm going to start the container with new option which gives me ability to interact with that container. And the options that I'm going to choose this time are hyphen I and hyphen T. So you can combine that using hyphen IT as well. And I'm going to use Docker container run hyphen IT, the image name. I'm going to use the same image. And if I use hyphen IT, it gives me a standard in and ability to interact. And I need to open a shell. It can be SH, it can be bash, it can be ZSH, whatever is available inside. Now it launched the container this time. I don't see the die event because it started the container and just resized, which means the container is still running. And in fact, in the top screen, I'm connected to the shell of that container. I'm going to run Docker PS and watch it. So I'll use a Unix utility called as watch to examine the what is happening inside it later. And if I go inside the container, I see that it's running with Alpine Linux. So it has, this is what a namespaced container looks like, because on top I see Alpine Linux. The bottom is the host which is running this container, which is still Ubuntu. And I see so many processes on that host, but inside the container, I only see the process that I launched, that is shell. This is a different, this is how namespaced containers look like. So even though it is an application running in an isolated environment on the same host, that's my, you know, footprint of the container on the actual host. It is actually running a process on the host, but inside that, it gives me its own PIDs and it gives me its own IPC and the process namespace. It also has the network namespace, which gives me the interface, which is E0, and an IP address that actually maps to a virtual interface on my underlying host, that is my Docker host on which this container is running. So that E0 has a mapping with V8 interface. This is called as V8 pair, and this is also the example of a network namespace. So I'm using watch command, watch with Docker PS, which shows me what is running currently. So the moment I exit from the container using Control D or exit command, that container just exited. That's what I see here. Now, what I've been using so far is just shell with Alpine, but I'm going to launch an actual application and show you what happens. And if I want to run a long running persistent container, I have to use that hyphen D option as well. Hyphen D, if you look at the difference, earlier it opened a shell and I was connected to it. Hyphen D detached from that so that I can run the commands on, I can come back to the shell and run it. And the container still is running. So if you look at the bottom part, monitoring console, it is still running. Now I'm going to launch another application using this image, school of DevOps slash loop, which has an application called as program. Now this pulls the image and it is going to start running a container. I am not using hyphen D option. I'm just using hyphen I and T. What I'm showing you is what happens if you use hyphen D and what, you know, if you don't use hyphen D. This is exactly what happens. The Docker is attached to the application and I cannot, you know, come back to the shell unless I use Control P and Control Q. So if I use hyphen IT, I still can detach from that using Control P followed by Control Q. That's what I did. But if I use hyphen D, it not only launches my application, but also immediately detaches from it. If I don't use hyphen I and T, I cannot even detach from that application. It is connected to the application. If I use Control P, Control Q, the exit escape sequence, it doesn't work. I have to use Control C, which kills the container. I can show you that. If I list last two containers, I see that the one I started with hyphen I and T is still running because I could gracefully detach from it. The one which I did not start with hyphen INT, I had to kill, so it is not running anymore. So using these three options, hyphen I, hyphen T, and hyphen D is always useful. That will launch a container, run it persistently, and it will allow you to run next command because it has detached from that container. And those are the options that you should definitely start using, hyphen I, D, and T, to make containers persist.